Everyone, please stand for the national anthem sung by the Aspen High School Choir.
And the rock is
Please be seated.
On behalf of the Aspen Board of Education, the administration, teachers, and all the staff of our great district, I want to welcome you, the soon-to-be graduates, your families, and extended families, to an event we weren't sure was going to happen only a few short months ago. You're going to hear several speeches this morning talking about resilience, perseverance, and integrity, to name a few of the topics. They will be worth paying attention to. Rather than talk about those incredibly important topics, I would rather focus this welcome on gratitude. And I would ask our graduates to take a moment and think about saying thank you, which is, as you know, a way of expressing gratitude. Later, please thank your parents and grandparents, indeed your whole family, for their love and support that have allowed you to be on this field today. So even if it is just mentally, say a thank you to the many teachers and staff members who have made your education possible. You are today a product of all the lessons and events that have occurred in your life. The coaches, the artists, the musicians, all the people who inspire you to be better tomorrow than you were today. Simply say thanks when you can. Today, if you think about it, we welcome all those people and events to this ceremony. This graduation ceremony is the symbol of all those experiences. I encourage the class of 2021 to welcome gratitude as an actual experience to this field, and actually all of your graduation events this weekend. But more importantly and immediately, I want to welcome all of our graduates and their families to this very special event. Thank you for being here today.
Students, faculty, and distinguished guests, it's my privilege to be here with you at the 132nd commencement ceremony of Aspen High School, and the first to be held on the AHS turf, followed by a ride up the Tyhack lift. Indeed, it will be our second celebration atop Buttermilk Mountain. And for that, I want to extend my utmost gratitude to SkiCo, specifically John Rigney, Joey Woltemath, Travis Benson, and their team. Today would not be possible without them. It is now my pleasure to introduce our stage guests. Audience, will you please hold your applause until all guests have been introduced? To our guests, please stand when your name is called. The Aspen School District Board of Education, Katie Frisch, Susan Marolt, Jonathan Nickel, Dwayne Romero, Dr. Susie Zimmett. From the school district, Dr. David Baugh, superintendent, Theron Mulberry, assistant superintendent, Becky Oliver, assistant principal, Josh Barrow, counselor, Karen Hawks, post-secondary counselor, Lauren Reese, counselor, Charlie Lobby, post-secondary counselor, and Scott Mercier, our commencement speaker. Thank you, guests, for being here today. There is another group of individuals I would like to recognize. Their hard work, flexibility, and dedication to academic excellence, their ability to pivot, have supported the accomplishments of the graduates here today. Will the faculty and staff of Aspen High School please stand and be recognized? And now I would like to have a special recognition for our retirees. Please stand and be recognized. Audience, if you could hold your applause. From Aspen Elementary School, Miss Tana Rinaldi, who has been an educator for 38 years. Ms. Kim Knoll, who has been an educator for 30 years. Julie Marcolunas Hall, who has been a speech language pathologist for 31 years. From Aspen Middle School, Mark Munger has been an educator for 42 years. And from Aspen High School, Callie Zohar, who has been an educator for 29 years. And Travis Moore, an Aspen High School graduate, who has been an educator for 25 years. Thank you to all of our retirees for giving so much to our students over the course of your careers. We will miss you and we wish you well. We will now have a musical act by our senior ensemble. I'd like to welcome Caprice Seaman to the stage, our senior class president.
Thank you, Sarah, and good morning, everyone. Today, we're celebrating one of the biggest landmarks in our lives. In the midst of a global pandemic, the class of 2021 has shown dedication, perseverance, and sacrifice. This moment, right now, is that much better because of it. No great accomplishment comes without its challenges. Our next speaker knows that all too well. Imagine you're in elementary school, struggling to verbally express your thoughts while trying to overcome a stutter. You're self-conscious, mentally frustrated, and embarrassed. It took dedication, perseverance, and sacrifice to overcome this incredible challenge. Fast forward, this Olympic cyclist credits these three words as his superpower to push beyond what others are willing to do. As a professional cyclist, he became Telluride's first Olympian, representing Team USA in the 1992 Barcelona Games after just 15 months of competitive racing. He finished his career as a member of the U.S. Postal Service's cycling team. He was valedictorian of his class at Telluride High School, earned a degree in economics from UC Berkeley, and is working on a master's in finance from the Harvard University Extension. He works as a financial advisor at Merrill Lynch, is a public speaker, and writes a cycling column for the Aspen Times. And if that's not enough, He's writing a book, Wind True, which will be published this summer. He lives in the Roaring Fork Valley with his family. He's a husband, father, and friend. It is my honor to introduce Aspen High School's 2021 commencement speaker, Mr. Scott Mercier.
Congratulations and thank you. There's two concepts that I think will serve you well as you take this next step in your life. And that is the suffering, learning how to suffer, and integrity. When I graduated from UC Berkeley in 1990, I wasn't ready to join the workforce, and my plan was to travel and backpack around the world for 2 years. But my dad thought that I should come home, bang nails for the summer, and race my bike. My brother was 15, and he thought it would be the last time we had to spend together. That summer, we didn't have any idea what we were doing. We would do intervals, we had no coach, up a hill towards the airport, and we'd do them over and over and over until we puked. And then we'd do a few more. And in a period of 6 weeks, I went from a Category 4 to a Category 2 road racer in the state of Colorado. I won almost every race I entered, and give you some perspective, that's the equivalent of maybe starting on the junior varsity to becoming a scholarship athlete in a period of 6 weeks. I decided to cut my trip short, so I backpacked throughout Southeast Asia for 7 months, came home with 10 bucks, moved to LA, and got a job bussing tables at a restaurant. That allowed me to train during the day and work at night to make some money. I was getting smoked every race I entered, because as a Cat 2, you got to race with the elites, the Cat 1s, and the pros, barely finishing. I was living with my biological dad. He'd spent a fair amount of money to put me through Berkeley. And he looks at me and says, "What are you doing with your life?" This is 1991. I said, "Dad, I'm going to the Olympics next year." He went crazy. He's like, "We're in LA. Why don't you be an actor? It pays better." And that's true. I know he wasn't trying to put me down, but you do have to, the part of that is you've got to believe in yourself. So I moved home to Telluride. My mom could see that something was wrong with me. I weighed about 150 pounds, and I picked up some sort of stomach ailment, I think in India. We got that cleaned up, and I went back to doing the same thing that had worked the previous year, intervals up the airport road until I puked. And slowly, I started regaining strength. My thought was that if I could become a Cat 1, and at that point, there were about 150 in the country, we're all skiers, so to put that in perspective, that'd be about 50 fist points, that I'd continue for one more year. And I knew that at the national championships, if I finished in the top 20, I'd automatically get my Cat 1 upgrade. In Park City, about halfway through the race, it was about a 100-mile, 8-mile circuit race, I flat. And just as I flat, the race explodes. People are going up the road. I have a rear flat, so I'm standing at the side of the road waiting for the support car to come by and give me a wheel change. It took about 3 minutes. I'm dead last, and I think my career as a cyclist is over. But I figure I'm going to finish the race. We've come this way. I want to see what I can do. And every time we get to the base of the circuit, the climb was very similar to the hill in Telluride. I'd look up the road, and there'd be eight guys, and I'd do a flat-out interval. And I'd catch that group, and I kept leapfrogging and leapfrogging and leapfrogging. And by the end of the race, I'm in the main peloton. There's about 25 guys. I have no idea how many guys are up the road. I attack that group, finish solo, and finish in 15th place. And I didn't know this at the time, but 15th was significant because that was the cutoff to make the national team. So in a period of about five, six months of racing, I went from nothing to the national team. And that got me invited to camps at the Olympic Training Center, where I had specific coaches teaching me how to be a better athlete. And one day, we're there in the fall, and they ask us to do some water play. And I'll tell you, when you go to the Olympic Training Center or some elite level like that, anything the coaches ask you to do is a test of some sort. If they want you to play ping pong, what they really want to see is what kind of hand-eye coordination you have. Well, for us, it was water play, and they asked us, why don't you guys see how far you can swim underwater? And some guys would do half a length or a full length. I did over 2 lengths swimming underwater, which was way more than anyone else had done. I came up beet red, practically drowned myself, and Charlie Livermore, one of the coaches, comes up to me and says, you should think about the team time trial. I said, great, Charlie, what's that? He kind of pauses for a minute and he says, don't worry, you'll find out. In March of 1992, I was invited to a camp for the team time trial. And the coach is going over the rules, he's on the whiteboard, he's going over curfew, diet, the type of training that we're gonna do. And then he drops what I consider to be a bombshell. He looks at us and he says, of the 12 of you in this room, 4 of you will be representing the United States at the Olympic Games in Barcelona. And I still get chills thinking about this because now I realized that I had a 1 in 3 chance of representing Team USA in the Olympics in an event that I'd never done. One of the chosen ones looks at me and he says, you are training fodder. You will never make the team. I would suggest don't say that to somebody you don't know anything about, because I filed that away and made sure I kicked his ass every single time. The training that we did was ridiculously hard. If you think of a motorcycle against a bike, the motorcycle is going to win every single time. And we'd have 12 guys motor pacing behind this motorcycle east of Colorado Springs going 30 to 35 miles an hour over the rollers. The motorcycle never gets tired. It was shrapnel. Guys are blowing up. Right behind the motorcycle, you get a big draft. You step off into the wind. You get hit with a wall of wind. You're going 10 to 12 miles an hour slower, and you have to sprint back to get on the tail. And when somebody blows, it's not the guy that just pulled off. It's the guy in fifth, sixth, seventh wheel. And you've got to be looking up the road to pay attention and do a Herculean effort to close that gap. I told myself I will never get dropped from the motorcycle. Every single time I was the last guy behind the motorcycle. And that earned me a spot on the A team. They divided us up into 2 teams for the Olympic trials, an A team and a B team, 4 riders each. This was gonna be my first event of the 100 kilometer team time trial. And to put this into perspective of how hard the 100 kilometer team time trial is, it's the equivalent of 2 hours doing wind sprints for 20 seconds, 60 second recovery, wind sprint again, 60 second recovering. It's one of the hardest events in what's a notoriously hard sport. Halfway through the race, we get a flat tire, we're over a minute down, and I think that's it, we're not gonna win the race. But we keep going, we're going steady, steady, steady. 70 kilometers into the race, 75 kilometers at the final turnaround, we're in the lead, we know we're going to win this race, we know we're going to the Olympics. But I gotta finish. This is my first time doing this event. With 15 kilometers to go, I start getting sick in my stomach. And I'm so scared. If I miss a pull at the front, I'll be dropped. God forbid I get dropped. I will not make the team. There's 100 guys that want my spot. I start vomiting. And I'm so scared that my coaches and teammates are gonna see that I'm weak, that I filled my mouth up and swallowed it back down. That's how badly I wanted to win and go to the Olympics, that I would swallow my own vomit. We won the race, we went to the Olympics, and that was probably one of the more humiliating days of my life. We finished 15 minutes down. In fact, I'm ashamed of our result. We finished with 3 riders, and we're 15 minutes slower than we were on a nearly identical course at the Olympic trials. But that led to a pro career. And of course, in cycling, just as in ski racing, you want to race in Europe. That's where the big leagues are. And 5 years later, I was hired by the US Postal Service's cycling team. And I knew that things were different immediately when the first thing they had us do at this training camp outside of San Diego was do a blood test. And Pedro Celaya was our team doctor, and he's going through the results of the blood test, and there's your iron on there, there's a variety of things, but what he's really looking for is your hematocrit. And he looks at mine, which was a score of 40, he goes, oh la la, to be professional in Europe, maybe 49, 49.5. And I look at him, I say, "Gracias, Pedro. How do I do that?" He says, "Special B vitamins. We talk later." So we go to Europe. I'm getting smoked in nearly every race that I'm entered. My morale is down. After the spring season, Pedro brings me into his hotel room in Geneva. We just finished the tour of Romandy. And he gives me a training program. It's a 2-week block of about 100 miles a day with intervals, hard intervals, 4 out of 5 days. And on this calendar that he gives me, there's dots and stars. And I go, "What are these for, Pedro?" He pulls out of his briefcase a Ziploc baggie filled with glass vials and green pills. And I say, "Pedro, what are these?" He said, "These are steroids. You go strong like bull. No racing. For sure you test positive." He asked me, "You know how you give yourself an injection, right?" And I said, "No." He was incredulous that he thought it was unbelievable a professional athlete didn't know how to give himself an injection. So he shows me how to do it. He says, "Put these in your pocket. And when you go through customs, tell them they're B vitamins." At that point, I didn't know what I was going to do. I put them in my pocket, got the hell out of his hotel room. I was living in South Africa. I flew home, talked to my wife. And I gave this some thought. And I knew that I would be a lot faster, but I also knew that it wouldn't end well. So I decided that I was going to not renew my contract, even though they wanted me, with the U.S. Postal for 1998. I had to remove myself from the situation. And if you think about what that is, if you think of integrity, the common definition really is doing the right thing when nobody is looking. But there's also historical and structural content to it. If you think of Glen Canyon Dam, the wholeness, the completeness, it's able to hold back millions and millions of gallons of water at Lake Powell. But if you were to drill a microscopic hole through that dam, it would lead to a bigger crack and a bigger crack, and eventually the entire structure would fall. Marine Corps General Charles Krulak gave a speech about integrity, and he talks about the root of the word for the Roman legionnaires. And they would shout out integritas when the centurions were listening for these inspections. And they would bang on their breastplate, and they would listen for the ring to make sure that it was true. And as you go, I have one simple task for you, which is also very hard. Wear your armor of integrity. Protect it. Guard it. It can't be bartered for. It can't be bought. Nobody can take your integrity away from you. It has tremendous value, but only you can protect it or give it away. Congratulations and thank you.
And now we will hear from the Aspen High School Choir.
Everyone. My name is Charlie Lobby, and I am one of the post-secondary counselors here at Aspen High School. At this time, I would ask for Jack Blocker and his parents to join me here at the podium. Jack represents the graduating class of 2021 as the co-salutatorian of Aspen High School. Among his many recognitions, Jack is the recipient of the prestigious Aspen Cancer Conference Scholarship, as well as the Pacesetter Science Award. He has dedicated countless hours helping to bring mental health resources to the Aspen community. Jack will be attending Brown University, where he will study biochemistry. Ladies and gentlemen, please show your appreciation for Aspen's 2021 co-salutatorian, Jack Blocker.
Hello, everyone. As everyone's already said, my name is Jack Blocker, class of 2021, and one of this year's co-salutatorians. First, I would like to acknowledge all of the teachers for their extraordinary efforts to make this and every year of high school the best possible learning experience. I especially want to thank Megan Noonan, Mark Whitley, Sarah Ward, Serena Sieber, Halen Gonzalez, and Sean Robinson for teaching me this year and helping me through all the IB and AP classes. And of course, thank you to the Post-Secondary Counseling Office for helping each and every student have the best possible plan moving forward. Charlie and Karen truly are guiding angels when it comes to the post-secondary counseling, and you helped me and each of my peers with securing a bright future. And on the note of our future, let me start with something I believe summarizes our past. Being a kid obsessed with science, the definition that I feel sums up both this year and the entirety of my high school experience is adaptation. Adaptation is defined as the change in process by which an organism or species becomes better suited to its environment. I thought it best to compare high school to this very thing. We can all say that our senior year was not as we imagined. There were very few sporting events to cheer on teams, no national or international science academic competitions, no parties, no large gatherings of our friends, no in-person classes for the half the year, and no college campus tours. But while everything was stripped away, something incredible occurred. We found ourselves in closely knit pods. We rediscovered nature, went for long runs, hikes, bike rides, and skied, although my parents and friends will say I don't actually know how to ride a bike. We became adept at virtual tours of college campuses and everyone's favorite, Zoom calls. We adjusted to online school. We all found ways to cope and excel. We have had an adult lesson thrust upon us before we even finished high school, but it is in our setbacks that we learn the most. I hope we will all look back on this time and not think of the opportunities that we missed, but the experiences that made us flourish. But our adaptiveness does not just apply to our senior year. I can confidently say that after going through the Aspen High School system for the Aspen school system for the past 8 years, that each student I have had the pleasure of working with has had a spine of steel and a hunger and willingness to change. Each of us is comparable to a single-celled organism, mutating to fit our environment and thriving. Whether it was waking up at 5 in the morning for early sports practices, or showing up at school at 7:30 to print a paper because your printer's out of cyan when you just want to print in black and white, or giving a presentation when public speaking gives you stomach pains, or, for some of us, it was watching our creatures that we put in tiny terrariums in freshman bio fail to adapt and having to explain, "I didn't know snails breathe so much oxygen." Our class knows how to take a bad experience and turn it into something that we will remember for the rest of our lives. We are extremophiles, finding ourselves in historic situations and still having an Aspen chill. Brown bears adapted to hibernate during winter. We adapted to going to school in pajamas, wrapped in a blanket, and getting up just 5 minutes before class started, ready, well, mostly ready, to learn. We learned how to form connections like penguins in the Antarctic in each new ex-ed group. Elephants never forget, just as we all hope to approximate after a night of cramming for a test. After all we've been through, nothing can stop us. We're Aspen saplings, trees ready to grow into breathtaking forests. I want to thank my family that traveled here to support me, and of course my grandparents, Lulu and Margie. And because I promised I would, Mom and Dad, I wouldn't be on this stage without you. You two are my single greatest supporters and my rock to anchor myself on. I love you guys bigger than the universe. And now, congratulations, class of 21! 2021, we did it!
Congratulations, Jack. Good morning, Aspen High School. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Karen Hawks, one of the post-secondary counselors here at Aspen High School. At this time, I would like to welcome Kendall Clark and her parents to join me at the podium. Kendall represents the graduating class of 2021 as the co-salutatorian of Aspen High School. She is a leader at our school, both in academics and athletics. Her teachers and coaches have said she's a natural role model for her peers. In addition to being an Aspen scholar, Kendall also received the Futures Fund scholarship this year. Kendall will be attending Chapman University, where she will be running cross country and track, and plans to study business administration and real estate. So please join me in welcoming and congratulating Kendall Clark.
Hello, everyone. I'm Kendall. Thank you, Karen, for the wonderful introduction. And first, I'd like to say thank you for all the parents for being here. Without the packed lunches, car rides, and your love and support, none of us would be here. And also, a huge thank you to all of our teachers from kindergarten to high school. You certainly aren't thanked enough, but please know that your time and your wisdom has helped us more than you know. And now to my fellow classmates of 2021. I've known many of you since we were 5 years old. The majority of my life has been spent going to school and growing up with all of you. Because of this and the community we have created, our success is collective. I'm sure that among this group of young scholars, as Miss Mo would call us, there were hundreds of hours of late night FaceTime calls, helping each other with math problems, probably thousands of texts, messages asking when is this due, and countless group projects. Our support for one another has not only helped each individual reach a higher potential, but it has made for an excellent class, which I am so proud to be a part of. And I could go on about the knowledge imparted to me during class hours, but while that information is extremely useful, there's something else stored in my mind that I find a little more valuable. And that is memories. To me, stories, experiences, and moments are like a currency I save up in my head, and with each new day, I get a little bit richer. I have a savings account full of memories of laughter and love, a checking account of adventures, and tons of new deposits flowing in with each second that passes. In my bank of life, there are shiny pennies that when they glint in the light, they remind me of the sun setting over the canyon on 7th grade outdoor ed. I have dimes that hold the many miles I have run with the cross-country team, and quarters full of field days and pep rallies, and dollar bills which hold the time I've spent with friends and family. Good and bad memories, triumphs and mistakes, accomplishments and unplanned adventures all have value which add to the quantification of my life. And sometimes, making a withdrawal from the bank of life is even better than the deposits. I hope we will all frequently make withdrawals to remember our mistakes and let it guide us better in the future. On days when we may be homesick and missing a good powder day, I hope you'll pull out a coin that reminds you of the excitement of seeing a rope drop on Highlands. Remembering can be almost as tangible as feeling the cold bronze of a penny between your fingers. When we remember, we're brought back to that time and that feeling. And in this way, we can make a moment infinite. And all of this is to say that memories are so much more valuable to me than money or objects could ever be. Throughout life, no matter how much my material worth may fluctuate, I'll always have my vault of memories, more precious than gold, in my head. So with that, I take the end of our high school career as a bittersweet payday. I thank you all, my fellow classmates of 2021, for the memories we have made in these past 18 years. From playing Foursquare at recess to lunch on the beach, to exit adventures and trying to learn calculus, I will remember and cherish each moment. And as for the future, I'm so looking forward for even more memories to roll in. Thank you and congratulations, skiers.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Josh Barrow, and I'm one of the counselors here at the high school. At this time, I would like for Alex Appleby and his parents to join me here at the podium. Alex Appleby represents the graduating class of 2021 as the valedictorian of Aspen High School. Alex is a recipient of the prestigious Principal's Award, and he is one of our Aspen scholars. Alex is also a member of the Black Forest Robotics Team, the top-ranked team in Colorado. Had the Robotics World Championships not been canceled, who knows how far this team would have gone. He will be attending Columbia University, where he will study computer science. Ladies and gentlemen, please show your appreciation for Aspen's 2021 valedictorian, Alex Appleby.
Side it's supposed to go on? All right. How do I sound? Woo! One sec. Today I learned that graduation robes do not have great storage options. So dig around for this a little bit. Hello, everyone. I'm Alex Appleby, and I am truly honored to be speaking in front of you all at the Aspen High School Class of 2021 graduation. I have the next 5 minutes to deliver a speech that is createful, creative, insightful, inspiring, maybe even tear-jerking, and most importantly, short. I regret to inform you, I'm not doing any of those, so don't get your hopes up. So if anyone has like emails you need to catch up on, texts to answer, voicemails, work stuff, now's the time. The truth is, I spent much of my 4 years of high school in my bedroom doing homework and in a basement building robots. For the most part, that's why I'm valedictorian, and that's why I think a good valedictorian speech is a bit of an oxymoron. In fact, not only am I unqualified for this position, I may be the least qualified person in this entire class. I'm like the Betsy DeVos of graduation speakers. I knew the teachers would love that one. I think we need Xavier Stapleton up here. That kid has like 20 underclassmen girlfriends. I want to know his secret. Or maybe we need George back. He's an actual junior Olympian. Round of applause. That kid has more athleticism in his pinky finger than I have in my entire body. I know that Lydia or Ella or V could give a much better performance on the stage, and I know that Caitlin or Asia or Tessa have a much better way with words than I do. I know that Hank Sweeney could have everyone cracking up. But here I am to give it the old college try. So if nothing else, I can present my perspective. Thus, I give the Basement Dweller's Guide to Aspen High School, and life beyond. And it's got my face on it. Rule one, savor every curry day. I speak for the students and faculty alike when I say that curry day is truly a sacred time in the Aspen High School Commons. Just a few weeks ago, I saw my good friend Jeremy Martin. We all know him, all love him. He was looking visibly sad in the Commons. I asked him, you know, what's up, dude? And he's like, man, Today is my last curry day. I really felt them in that moment. It was tough. Life is like lunch at Aspen High School. You know, there are only so many curry days, and there's only so much time we have on this earth. Life's just too short to skip curry day. Rule 2, drive a red Mini Cooper. Whenever I give someone a ride for the first time, they inevitably ask me the same question. They're like, Alex, you're a total stud, right? You're 6 foot tall, ripped, you know, Hollywood bound. You might be James Bond someday. And they're like, you know, like, why do you drive that little hipster clown car? You know, you should be behind the wheel of like a Hummer or like a cement mixer, you know, something like masculine, I don't know. And my answer is always the same, because it's a totally awesome car. Sure, my head touches the roof, but I wouldn't have it any other way. In high school and in life in general, people will try to put you in a box. Conformity is expected, but honestly, it's kind of overrated. Do what you feel like and don't be afraid to go against the current. I might get some weird looks, but I guarantee you I can fit into parking spots that your mind can't even comprehend. Rule 3, join the robotics team. As everyone in Aspen High School can attest to, being a member of the robotics team is a one-way ticket to popularity and success. You have no idea how many parties I've been invited to. I'm a legend that pinned the tail on the donkey. That is what you guys do at parties, right? Okay, fine, maybe that's a bit of an exaggeration, but I do have a story to tell you. I came into high school as what us kids would refer to as a total sweat. Yeah, that's slang for try hard for all the boomers in the audience. I was the first chair clarinetist, a varsity football player. I did summer school. Let me clarify, I willingly did summer school. And then one day I sort of just stopped. I didn't really enjoy any of it, and instead I decided to take an enormous leap of faith. I dropped everything to sit in a sweaty basement and work on a robot. Frankly, it was the best decision I ever made. You don't have to join the robotics team, but you guys should join the robotics team. But I encourage you not to be afraid to take your own leap of faith as well. That's all for chapters 1 through 3. Test on Monday. I expect you all to be prepared. Before I go, I'd like to take the opportunity to thank some of the people who make AHS an amazing place. Firstly, I'd like to thank Sarah Strasburger and the rest of the administration. They certainly had their work cut out for them this year, and I think they did a really amazing job dealing with all the challenges. I'd also like to thank the wonderful teachers and faculty that I've had over my 4 years here. I would single you out by name, but I always hated it when you did that to me in class, so I'll spare you. And of course, I'd like to thank all of the parents in the crowd for raising these crazy people. I know that everyone in this graduating class could fill their own book. Maybe it won't be this big, but I know that they could all fill their own book with lessons that AHS has taught them, and I can't wait to see where everyone's lessons will take them. I'm going to miss you all as much as Jeremy Martin is going to miss Curry Day. Thank you.
Slow down, you're crazy child. You're so ambitious for a juvenile. But then if you're so smart, tell me why are you still so afraid? Where's the fire? What's the hurry about? You better cool it off before you burn it out. You got so much to do and only so many hours in a day. Hey, but you know that you can get what you want, or you can just get old. You're gonna kick off before you even get halfway through. Ooh. it's for you. Slow down, you're doing fine. You can't be everything you wanna be before your time. Although it's so romantic on the borderline tonight, tonight. Too bad, but it's the life you lead. You're so ahead of yourself that you forgot what you need. Though you can see when you're wrong, you know you can't always see when you're right, you're right. You've got your passion, you've got your pride, but don't you know that only fools are satisfied? Dream on, but don't imagine that disappear for a while. It's alright, you can't afford to lose a day or two. Ooh, when will you realize Vienna waits for you? And you know that when the truth is told, that you can get what you want, or you can just get old. It's alright, you can't afford to lose a day.
Wow, I hate to follow that. I'll be brief. I know it's hot out there. Seniors, this is it. You have made it. Today, you will not only cross that metaphorical bridge to a new life post-high school, you will also literally cross the Tyhack Bridge to celebrate your success. I think we can all agree, we've heard it already, that this year has been trying, and it's not how you imagined your senior year. But the class of 2021 has not only weathered a global pandemic, you've also continued the tradition of excellence at our school. And despite online learning, quarantines, hybrid learning, the loss of your traditional rites of passage, this class stands as an exemplar of the very best we have to offer. And here you are, without your masks. I bring this up not to point out the obvious, but to give you a tangible example of all the cliches that have no doubt been thrown at you this year. Make lemonade out of lemons, this too shall pass, rainbows only come after the rain, and so on. And here's the thing about cliches, they exist because there is a truth to them. And here you sit, living proof that you can meet challenges head on, challenges that no generation has faced in a century. As I look out at all of you, I'm reminded of our homecoming car parade and bell ringing ceremony, new traditions that grew out of COVID. I think about our prom reception and the Cupid Shuffle and our recent ex-ed, and I stand here in awe of all of you. I'm also filled with hope. You've had to navigate a brand new world of Zooms, Google Classrooms, and yet you persevered. You realized you had to forge ahead and apply to college, take IB, AP, and industry exams, play your sports in different seasons, some of which are still going, forego live music for most of the year, and yet here you are. Every single one of you has survived a global pandemic and has a clear plan for your future. As you sit here today, I want you to look at the beauty that surrounds you, the love and admiration of your family and staff and friends that surrounds you. And like Dr. Boss said, I want you to remember gratitude. You are here, unmasked, smiling, graduating. Go out into this world knowing that you can face anything that comes your way. And remember that while you cannot control what life throws at you, you can control how you choose to live. Focus on all that you have, not on what you do not. Approach others with kindness and compassion, for who knows what they are enduring. And look for opportunities rather than lament misfortunes, all the things that you have learned and lived this year. Students of the class of 2021, as you finish your last year of high school, and I conclude my first as your principal, please know how honored I am to be standing here with you today. Your collective compassion, sense of humor, diligence, and tenacity will stay with me for my lifetime. You will be sorely missed, not only by me, but also by the staff and other students of Aspen High School. We look forward to hearing about all that you accomplish. And as alumni, you will always be welcome to your home, Aspen High School. Go skiers. Dr. Zimmet, the seniors before us have satisfied the graduation requirements set forth by the Aspen's Board of Education. On behalf of the entire staff at Aspen High School and the Aspen community, I present these seniors to you to accept this senior class for diploma distribution.
As president of the Aspen School District Board of Education, I accept the principal's recommendation and I certify that each of you has met or exceeded the requirements for high school graduation set forth by the state of Colorado and the Aspen School District Board of Education. Therefore, it is my distinct privilege and honor to proclaim to all present and beyond that you are indeed graduates of Aspen High School.
Maya Elizabeth Abraham. Noah Alexander Aiken. Connor Creighton Allen. Jack Henry David Alter. Alexander Blake Appleby. Story Rose Balco. Sasha Ray Farlazzini. George Christopher Beck. Hayes O. Benenson. Jack Howard Blocker. Presley Margaret Brennan. Max Johann Brenninger. Aaron Keeley Bretman. William Thomas Paul Boltman. William James Cairncross. Arlette Julissa Campuzano. Johanna Sarai Kantav. Jocelyn Alexa Carreño. Ethan Charles Chambers. Miller James Clapper. Kendall Sue Clark. Sean Thomas Connolly. Audrey Nicole Corcoran. Bryce Courts Pierce. Angelica De La Torre. Jameson Rose Delaney. John Francis Doyle III. Sophie Caroline Durham. William Allen Fari. Wesley James Calvin Farrell. Asher Mitchell Fight. Noah Benjamin Foreman. Connor James Gagan. Andrea Yamilet Gonzalez. Gallegos. Andrea, forgive me. Samantha Vanessa Gonzalez. Tessa Elizabeth Guthrie. Yeah. John Christopher Hall. Zuleika Sasha Hansen. Gavin Stewart Heil. Luke Alvin Hollander. Tyler Kenny Holman. Macy Adelaide Hopkinson. Leah Joran Horning. Elijah William Hunt. Dyer Ives Hunting. Daniel Alexander Jansen. Stella Lilia Annalie Johansson. Tatum Ophelia Johnson. Ella Santi Joseph. Christian Alexander Kelly. James Scott Kelly. Chase Reed Kennedy. Colson Cash Kennedy. Kylie Elizabeth Kenny. Landon Worth Kiker. Emily Melissa Kinney. Charles Klein. Kaylin Ferris Krager. Emma Elizabeth Kuhn. Yeah. Taylor Mills Lang. Lucy Ray Lampy. Evelyn Jean Leibinger. Audrey Rose Lynn. Sophia Ann Lynn. Hunter Lee Love. William Harrison Madsen. Alec Fred Martell. Alexander Joseph Martin. Eleanor Kimbrell Martin. Jeremy Todd Martin. Ruby Lynn McBride. Ava Mae McDonough. Kelsey Latusik McHugh. Diego Sebastian Mendoza. Keaton Cobb Miller. Regan Ann Mitchell. Tyga McLean Moore. Thomas Casper Morris. Alexander Mosier. Annika Arliss Nichols. Caitlin Christine Ann O'Callaghan. Guadalupe Del Rosario Ortiz. Yeah. Martin Palmaz. Sebastian Pierre Pettinelli. Spencer Allen Purley. Olivia Marie Plummer. Lars Christian Pomeroy. Alexander Brockway Potamkin. Jack Morris Power. Ashley Azanette Ramos. Carolina Sagaro Robinson. Braden Albertson Rogers. Grace Elaine Romero. Robert Allen Sanderson. Asia Bell Schiller. Cosma Schultze. Caprice Alexandra Seaman. Oliver James Semple. Andrew William Seibold. Jackson Clifford Sheridan. Yeah. Edith May Sherlock. Victoria McLena Cedars. Storm Marcel Paul Sillett. Amanda Marie Simone. Tyler Harlan Smart. Megan Elizabeth Smitty. Christina Pearl Soderberg. Kristen Marie Spang. Chloe Jean Springfield. Xavier Charles Stapleton. Lydia Catherine Seislinger. Matilda Rose Swanson. Henry William Sweeney. Ava Jane Thornley. Lucas Elon Trailens.
Finally, let's go.
Delaney Margaret Tuller. Lillian Louise Valentine. Harwood James Valentine Wilson. Andrew Enzo Vallone. John Paolo Viola. Sienna Rose Webb. Jonathan David Weiss. Stephanie Angeline Wojcik. Lily Ann Woolman. Margaret Louise Woodrow. Hannah Rose Yeary. Sierra Ashley Zanier.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time we will have our head girl, Grace Romero, and head boy, Jeremy Martin. They are going to lead our graduates in the changing of the tassel. Graduates, would you please stand? Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Aspen High School's graduating class of 2021. Thank you.